Three myths that drive me crazy. One, if you're against teacher unions, you're against teachers. Two, guns make homes less safe. Three, the government's always looking out for my best interests. Really?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, number one. If you're against school, if you're against teacher unions, you're against teachers. Nonsense, okay? Good teachers don't actually benefit from unions because unions make sure that teachers, all teachers get a certain amount of money. Well, if you're performing better than another teacher, then why would you want to have the exact same income as the other teacher? It makes no sense. It keeps the crappy teachers as well as the really good teachers. That's not good for the students, and it's not good for the teachers, ultimately. Teachers' unions are often very corrupt, and they also support bureaucrats and people who help feed money to certain individuals. There's a lot of cronyism, a lot of favoritism in that type of system, and what happens is they draw and draw and draw more resources to the point where the state has to make these extreme cuts, which is why you see the teacher unions ultimately get broken across the country. You see even the good teachers get paid less money. I don't want to see good teachers get paid less money. I don't want to see good teachers get screwed. I don't want to see good teachers go without health care. That's ridiculous. I just think that we need to cut down on all this administration. We need to actually have a system where it's easier to get rid of the crappy teachers, and it's easier to reward the really good teachers. I'm just asking for more accountability and fairness, really, on both sides. As far as these vouchers, you hear a lot of nonsense. People say that, oh, well, the test scores aren't really that much better. Well, there was a CREDO study that showed that there was actually a negative effect when you look at the charter schools and the conventional schools, when you look at the test scores, there's a negative effect. Well, actually, when you look at the study, you find out that first, a lot of data wasn't even randomized. Two, they actually acquired some demographic data to create something that's called virtual twins. They weren't even actually comparing actual kids in charter schools to actual kids in conventional schools. And Carol Huxby, who is from Stanford University, a researcher, she pointed that out in her paper also for CREDO. She also did a report on New York City schools, and they found that when you actually look at kids who went into charter schools and kids who didn't go into charter schools, the test scores were better. Significantly better for the kids who went into the charter schools. Now, a lot of people say that, well, you know, this is because the kids going to charter schools are more motivated than the kids who don't, and the parents are more motivated. Not true. In this study, they actually looked at people, groups of people who actually applied for the charter schools, and they had a lottery. Some kids got in, some kids did not. The kids that got in end up having higher test scores, higher math scores. I think it was somewhere a difference of 650 to versus 680. So there's a significant difference. Now, both groups were obviously motivated. The only difference is one group was selected by the lottery and one group wasn't. So it just shows you. And there's another Pennsylvania study that was actually looking at charter schools and its effect. The 16-state study is the one that showed a negative effect of charter schools, but that's the one in which they had really bad research methods. So, again, you know, it's just another myth that, you know, if you don't support these big unions, you're against the teachers. Nonsense. Okay, second myth. Guns make homes less safe. Complete nonsense. Two stories you'll never really hear. In Flint, Michigan, in April, two guys broke into this woman's house. She shot one. One guy got away. Actually, they both got away. And one guy who was shot, he collapsed down the street. The police came, took him to the hospital. He was arrested. Obviously, her gun didn't make her less safe. Obviously, her gun didn't make her house more dangerous. Okay, the creep trying to kick in the door made her house more dangerous, and she was able to protect herself with that gun. Another case in May, a woman, she was in her home, a 16-year-old guy, he was kicking down the door, and she said she had a gun. He came in anyway. She shot him. Okay, he's dead. Police investigated. They let her go. Now, did the gun make her less safe? Okay, third myth that drives me crazy. Now, the government is always looking out for our best interests. Oh, really? Sure. Okay, well, in Indiana, the Supreme Court ruled that, you know, even though a police unit may illegally enter your house, you don't have the right to use force against them. Okay, why? Well, their argument was that they didn't want the situation to escalate towards violence. Well, you know, if the police are kicking down your door and they don't have a legal means to do it, and they're putting guns in your face, don't you think that's an escalation of violence? But what they're saying is, by ruling 3-2, at least two people had some good sense, that, you know, the police, you have to, even though the police may do that, you have to figure that out in court. You can challenge that in court. Ah, so you see how they're moving us closer towards a situation where we're pretty much in a almost like a police state. It's not just it. The Immigration and Customs Agency uncovered a list of 5,200 people that they suspected in the Pentagon who were viewing child pornography. And, you know, the DOD looked into it, and they only, they pretty much didn't investigate most of the people. And they found a list of 300 people who probably looked at it on their home computers or their work computers. Why wouldn't you want to investigate something like this? And how much of a compromise would you have in that entire organization if you had this many people suspected of doing this type of wrongdoing? Or is this some type of operation to just set up a large amount of people so that they can actually control them? You always hear people say that, well, you know, you can't keep anything secret in the government, blah, blah, this. Well, not true. The Manhattan Project with the nuclear weapons is a perfect example of a government operation in which thousands of people were involved. They were able to keep it secret. This, you know, if this many people are compromised, who's controlling all these people, you know? You can obviously keep people quiet. So, you know, this idea of, well, the government's always doing what's best for us. Yeah, well, okay. Well, it depends on who us you're referring to. You're referring to Goldman Sachs. You're referring to the big bailout banks. yeah, they're always doing what's best for them. Yeah. You know, Social Security, you know, people talk about that. Now Social Security is in a yearly deficit. Yearly deficit, they're saying that, well, we can afford to pay. Basically, it means that they're paying out more than they're actually bringing in. Well, you know, we could pay 3/3 of it all the way up to year 2036. Why 3/3? Why don't you tell us how much you have enough to pay for 100%? Okay, we could pay Medicare 90% of Medicare all the way up to 2024. Oh, really? Well, how much is 100%? And by the way, if you look closely at the articles, it says if current trends continue. So the Japanese are finally admitting that, okay, yeah, we had a full meltdown. Oh, really? You think? it took them forever to admit that. Okay, this is a major disaster. Oh, really? 4 nuclear reactors compromised? It's a major accident? Thanks for letting us know. A Swiss study actually linked cell phones to the deaths of bees, which is really, really interesting. Guys, check out that link. Last and certainly not least, the United Arab Emirates. Well, the Americans are now studying if it's legal for them to have a private military in that country. Apparently Blackwater is involved. Well, I think people should study Blackwater. Keywords, Blackwater, Iraq, atrocity. Study that, okay? I like how they changed their name to XE. You know, I love it when corporations change their names, you know. Forget about Murder and Rape Incorporated. How about Sunshine Coming Out of My Butt Incorporated? As if that really changes what they really do. Anyway, we hit the debt ceiling of $14.3 trillion, and now the federal government is going to dip into pension funds of their workers. Gee, I wonder what the state governments are going to do. Anyway, actually the real debt, when you look at the obligations of Social Security and Medicare and all that stuff, is actually closer to $50 trillion. But hey, many, many times GDP. But hey, you know, we have the dollar, and we just print more of those, and, you know, we'll be all right. It's not like China and Russia are plotting ways to ditch the dollar. Oh, wait. All right, guys, have a good day, and don't forget the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.